Idaho, 2017.
First morning out. There's Michael Parrott looking for a bull elk. House down. Happened too quick to get it on film.
Grouse down. Grouse down.
Grouse down. First Idaho grouse.
He's right there. This is crazy.
She's down, bud. I was walking right here looking in there.
Jeez.
She was the whole time.
What?
Didn't even see her till I got up there and looked over.
Oh, nice, dude.
Hold on. Well, we're here in Idaho, and the last day of the hunt, finally got it done. It's a real dream come true, killing one of these animals. There's nothing like it until you do it.
It's amazing.
I was up here glassing this mountain this evening, and wasn't having much luck, just about ready to give up. And I was just packed up all my stuff, getting ready to move spots, and I looked to my left, and there she was standing. And I was like, this is my opportunity. And it was a little far shot. It was 80 yards, but I was able to capitalize on the shot, and she didn't go maybe 50 yards. And it's just a dream come true. Something I've always wanted to do.
Hey, good job, buddy.
Not the big 6x6 that everyone hopes to kill when they come out here, but it's a lot harder than what everyone thinks. And this is just a real accomplishment. Just awesome trying to take it all in. We're on the top of this mountain right now, and there's elk bugling everywhere. The rut is really starting to pick up. There goes one just right there. Just a great hunt. Couldn't do it without Josh. He's gonna have a fun pack with me. We had a heck of a hunt.
Hey, it's worth it.
We killed a few grouse, a few pine squirrels, but most of all, we got us an elk.
Heck yeah.
We're ready to head back to Ohio.
The fun begins now.
We're out here in Idaho. Rifle season for bull elk. He's going for a bull elk, I'm going for a black bear, so we'll see what happens. Got camp set up right here on top of this mountain. Make sure we can hear the bugles in the morning. Wish us luck.
Some bulldog tracks right here.
Starting to get tired of these mountains. They're nice and steep, but finally seeing lots of elk, so that's a plus.
season, Idaho. Tonight's the last night we're gonna stay. We're gonna go through Yellowstone. And we had a good trip. We've seen lots of wildlife, lots of moose. Three bulls, two rag bulls, one 6x6 that I did shoot. He was about 300 yards. I hit him good, looked good. And his second shot was back a little bit. And he was angled away from me as he was walking away. But we had a really good blood trail. Unfortunately, there was another guy. He was actually tracking these elk all day on the side of the mountain. And he pushed it out. That's when I seen it and shot it. He wasn't too happy that I shot it, the elk that he was tracking all day. We started tracking the elk. Once it started to go up the mountain more, I told him, I said, we need to back off. Give him a half hour. The guy's like, no. He's like, he's gonna bleed out. That's good blood. He goes, I'll circle. Well, he ended up circling. We're tracking it. We ended up tracking this elk for like an hour and a half. Halfway up the mountain, the guy got on the blood trail and he was tracking my blood trail. We could see where he pumped the elk up twice. It laid down, left a good bloody spot. So we started hollering up the mountain, you know, let him know that we have it and that we can get it ourselves. We can find it. Well, we never heard anything from him. We sat up there. We had about 15 minutes till dark. We had an hour and a half to get back to the truck. So we sat there just about dark. We didn't hear nothing. We're like, all right, we're gonna back out. We'll be back in. The next morning, we'll go back up the mountain and get it. Well, next morning we got up there. There's footprints everywhere. They took the elk. They tagged it. He went and got his buddies. They got it. They must have did it through the night. It's a shame. I mean, I know if he thinks I'm not tagging the elk, it's game. Because if I thought somebody was giving up on something, I would tag it. But we told him from the beginning I wasn't giving up. We'll get it tomorrow if we had to. He knew what he was doing. That's a shame. That's the end of the elk season. We got about 20 minutes left here. Who knows? That tag's good for a mountain lion, a bear, a wolf, or an elk. But our main focus has been an elk. Maybe next season.
Thanks to you.
B for bison.
so hard. Salt Fork. Shot a doe this morning. Tried to do a double, get Jarrett shot here, but went behind some brush and she ended up running around over the hill. So he couldn't take a shot at her, but I got to take a shot at this nice sized doe and put some meat in the freezer.
Into the Stream Ministries.
This is Into the Stream Ministries.
Getting real.
I was out here calling this morning, didn't hear anything. Circled the property, saw three toms, about six hens working our way to where we were sitting, so we're headed back out. Took a little video of them next to the road. See if we can make it happen. Dad's shooting today. Today, wish him luck. Trying to stay on top of the hill, aren't they?
Yeah. He's kind of hit on both sides.
Well, Dad got it done. Turkey spurred me.
Three toms.
Couldn't video, they were looking right at us.
There was a hen in front of us, so we couldn't turn the phone on. but we did figure something out, didn't we?
Yeah.
We'll keep that a secret. We figured out how to call them in when they're held up.
Had a 9:30 bird. Headed out. Probably the coolest hunt ever. Said to say I couldn't video any of it.
So many birds, and they're gobbling nonstop.
Boys, it's a rainy day, got it done, took about a 9-inch beard, three quarters of an inch spurs, not huge, but I'll take it. Tried getting on video by myself. It's not always easy to video yourself and shoot a turkey. Had to jump up and shoot him again, so, well, yep, there he is. Now, for the walk home. Oh, you know, just getting it down here in the morning. Got it done today.